The next property of logarithms has to do with exponents, or powers. When we have log base b of x to the a, we can really set that equal to a times log base b of x. In other words, we just take this exponent of a and we bring it down in front of our logarithm as a coefficient. In other words, if I have log of base 10 of 100 to the third power, we can rewrite this. We can bring this third power down in front of our logarithm, so we'll have 3 times the logarithm of base 10 of 100. Now, I usually put this in parentheses so I understand that it's 3 times this quantity. And let's carry out the math on both sides of the equation to make sure that this makes sense. On the left-hand side, we'll have log of base 10 and then 100 to the third power. Well, 100 to the third power is the same thing as a million. That's 1 followed by 6 zeros. On the left-hand side, we'll have 3 times the log base 10 of 100. Log base 10 of 100 is 2. We know this since 10 squared equals 100. We're looking for the exponent that we'd raise 10 to in order to get this number. So we know 3 times 2 equals 6, and now let's check the left-hand side. We'll have log base 10 of a million. Well, we know a million is 1 followed by 6 zeros. So that means we have to raise 10 to the 6th power in order to get a million. So yes, 6 equals 6. This is just one example of why this log property holds true. And finally, here's the last logarithm property we'll examine. If we subtract two logarithms that have the same base, then we can just divide the two numbers. So the log with base b of x minus the log of base b of y equals the log of base b of x divided by y. For example, the log of base 3 of 81 minus the log of base 3 of 9 would equal the log of base 3 of 81 divided by 9. We simply just divide these two numbers inside of our argument and take the log of it. And let's also be sure that this checks. We know the log of base 3 of 81 equals 4, since 3 to the 4th equals 81. We also know the log of base 3 of 9 equals 2, since 3 squared equals 9. And finally, on the right-hand side, we'll have the log of base 3 of 81 divided by 9. We know 81 divided by 9 really equals 9, so we have log with base 3 of 9. Now we can just subtract here, so we get 2 equal to 2. We know log of base 3 of 9 is really just 2, as before. Now, using those log properties, I want you to try and write this expression with one logarithm. In other words, you should have the log with base b of one number here. Now, it's okay if you're not entirely sure what to do. I just want you to try your best. Think back to what it means when you add logs together and when you subtract logs together. Do them one at a time, and I think you might get to the answer. And again, it's totally okay if you don't get there. You can always see the solution.